We are at Symbiosis right now, and we will shortly begin the part two of today's session. By the time the slides get uploaded here, I would like to just give a small introduction to that session. Last time we tried this visual communication sessions followed by assignment where faculty members submitted their slides on a particular topic. These slides were supposed, because they were submitted by each and every person, we used a technique called peer evaluation or peer review. The inference was not very encouraging in a way, because a lot of faculty members were not aware of the process to be followed for a peer review. Therefore, we had situations where kind of average presentation being given 0 marks at times by some peers and on 10 marks also by some other peers. Thankfully, because we had multiple reviews of the same document, we did not depend on only one. So the extreme cases were, we didn't hit us much. But I visit various remote centers, a couple of people do complain even now, saying that because of that thing, I lost 3 marks and then I am not in the associate faculty list today. So such is the case of that. That prompted us to take a new look at how to do this. And we have come up with a new plan this time. And I am going to share this in the following session, simply because it is a huge topic to think about because of the subjectivity involved in it. So when you say colors, like I was just talking about, or fonts, choice of layouts, then everybody have their own opinion and they are strict about it. So you cannot counter it by saying, no, this layout is only the good layout. Therefore, what we have thought of is having a two-level peer evaluation process. I am sure you must have read the document about peer evaluation. Is it available right now? No. Okay. So it will be available. I think Jay Krishnan has put that massive responsibility on my shoulders now, that I should introduce this topic and also share with you. Did you get it? Not yet? Okay. So I was talking about the seeing of the process. In between, by the time this happens, there are some questions from various places. So let us just take one of the questions by the time. So we have NDMVP Samaj, and they have a question.
Sir, what should be the proportion of media, whether it is graphics or videos, in a presentation?
So I got the question. What should be the proportion of visual and or any type of media in a presentation? I think the answer is cannot be given in terms of like percentage. You have do chutki namak type. I can't give that type of answer. It is the same answer what people give in cookery shows, namak swadanusar. So it is because no, you can't quantify these elements. For example, you are explaining, and it is there in my presentation also, that video. For example, you are talking about quantifiable elements in a research study, whatever you have done, and you have to compare that with A to B, B to C, C to D, and A to D also. Then you have a bar chart or you have a table. And that becomes an important element. Maybe you will write very little about it because you will only write the inferences about it and just show the table bigger size. But when you use something like maybe turbines and something electrical, this suppose that is the topic, and you put a huge turbine photograph in every slide properly, then that is taking away the audience from you. So that is where I mean. So if you put a background of the turbine picture in all the slides, just because the topic is about turbines, it is 100% visuals, but zero effectiveness. So use it. I think I go with Sanjeev Kapoor. Namak Swadanusar is the right answer there. We'll take one more question and then we'll go. So we are transferring the floor to any LIT. Please go ahead with your question, sir.
Actually, this is not related to the visual presentation session, but my submission was that I'd like to share a success story on ICT implementation that happened in J&K State, and I'd like to have a kind intervention of Professor Pathak also, because somehow he has been directly or indirectly responsible for this success story. So am I permitted to raise this question in this session?
I am not sure whether Professor Pathak would be there to listen to this, but nevertheless, I would I have a better suggestion for this, not because of the timing constraint, but because you are talking something very important. I would really request you to maybe create a small little video clip about whatever you are talking, and please send it to us, because we are in the process of documenting all these success stories, and this thing can be of good help. Okay, I just get a message that he is there. So I request J&K to please go ahead and share your story in the shortest possible time. Thank you.
We have been part of this teaching learning exercise for a long time now, and we have been associated with Professor Pathak directly. In J&K, you know, not many success stories come out of J&K, and J&K is in the news for most of the time for wrong reasons. But this time we have been designated as the technology partner of J&K schools, and we have been instrumental in establishing 450 smart classrooms in the schools of J&K. Now these schools are mostly established in the remotest areas, you know, bordering areas of J&K state. This is one aspect of it. Second aspect is that we have been also instrumental in capacity building of over 5,000 teachers of J&K school education. Now, in promoting e-learning, now that has brought a tremendous change on the ground. In fact, it's all documented. I mean, students of remotest schools have started now, you know, engaging themselves through various sessions. A lot of schools are being networked and common programs are being, beamed. We have been also talking to AVU team so that we can use their interface for networking of all these schools while ICT sessions are being beamed out. So I'm looking forward to mentoring and guidance from Professor Pathak so that we can do a lot of value addition to our current program. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we will take back the floor, J&K, and I'll see if I can get a response of Professor Pathak. I'm suddenly feeling like I am in a newsroom right now, and I'm running a new channel kind of thing. I'm sorry for that. But okay, can we go over to NMIT quickly to see Professor Pathak respond to this? Over to Nitya Meenakshi Institute.
Digressing from the topic at hand, but my thanks and appreciation to our friends from J&K. I think I would like to emphatically tell all our 7,000 participants that in spite of the situation in J&K not being tranquil, this center has been working with us for all these years, and not only this center, but a large number of faculty members from different colleges have been coming even under adverse circumstances and attending this program. I think the takeaway for all of us is that in spite of difficulties, we show our commitment and passion, and J&K and particularly this center is one such reflection of extreme commitment and extreme passion. I thank them and I thank all of you. Over to you, because I think we are impeding on the lunch time of our participants. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir, and thank you all the remote centers who have put up that question mark there, but I am really sorry because I have to rush into the presentation now. Let us just go through this activity. It's very important. Please pay attention, and we'll go ahead fast now. Go next. You can go even next without telling me now. So I have covered most of this part, but one point: requires practice and clarity of thought while doing the peer reviewing is because if you jumble up in these goof, if you goof up in these assumptions, then there is a huge chance of skewing the results completely. So be sure of this. So we will go ahead and we'll see step by step of what is there. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are going to upload a rubric document that is going to have seven rows. Seven rows meaning that there are seven criteria on which you are going to evaluate the given submissions of your peers. Remember, peers are nobody but teachers like you, and so they are also equally present in terms of creating these slides and sharing and all that. So you have to consider that fact while doing this. And the criterion, I will just explain one by one so that it is clear. So the top portion of the slide is an example or a screenshot of a submission. And the bottom portion, if you can read it, I'm not very sure. I am is about the explanation of the rubric of it. So just read that and tell me locally here that for this submission, how will you rate it? So the options are, if too many, more than three fonts are used in the presentation, or too many font options are used in the presentation, both come under one bucket. So either of the thing is also a eligible case for giving it a low rating. On the other side, if there are two fonts in the presentation, but those are not readable because of the font size, or some font options are unnecessary, like I showed the bold, italic, underline, color red, all that, then again you give a medium level thing. However, if it is two fonts used which are readable and appropriate usage of font is done, then you can give it 2 marks, which is high, right? So what will you grade this particular submission as? How many people will go with 0? Let me try out. Oh, 0. Why 0? How many fonts are used here? Fonts meaning the name of the font. And second is too many font options. So font sizes is an option. Font is, how many fonts can you see here? Okay, only 2 fonts. So they pass on that case. But because they have not done the other part, so then there are 2 fonts in the presentation, but those are not readable, is the point you wanted to say. So you are in actually bucket number 1 and not 0. This is precisely the mistake which happened last time a lot, that people by mistake did it 0 because they thought, what is the definition of a font? So they thought ek chota font, bada font. It's not chota font, bada font. It is chota font size versus bada font size of the same font. So that is a mistake, right? I can see that people are also going for 1, 2, 2, lot of people for 1 and 2. But I can hardly see a 0 here, which is a good thing. Okay, good. So a lot of people agree to 1, even in other parts of the country, which is very good. Let us go next and it will complicate the matter further. Go ahead. Okay, so use of color. Too many colors. Colors are too bright, too pale is 0. Some unnecessary colors and some colors are bright or pale is 1. Appropriate colors and all colors have appropriate contrast is 2. So how many will go for 0? Okay, so too many zeros. And except for, oh my god, it is going so fast, I can't even read it. This is one of the most interesting sessions I had, where the chat is running like a video now. I remember that joke where that the fan in the hell was running because of the sins performed by some people. So there was a clock and it used to go 1 second every time a sin was performed. And somebody was saying, where is the sin for some ex-politician? He said that we use as a fan because it is coming so fast that we have to use it as a fan. It is like that now. Okay, go ahead. Okay, slide background. Too much clutter in the background, making unable to read. Background makes it difficult to read in some slides, and perfect use of background to make the slide readable and aesthetically beautiful. Okay, so here is a catch. What will you grade this slide as? 1? Okay, why 1? Background makes it difficult to read in some slides. Why? Which slide is difficult to read? This is the title slide, right? How do you know other slides will be difficult to read, or this is the difficult to read slide? We'll have the same background. These are the assumptions you are making. Okay, fine, fine. Fair enough. He's right. He's saying that if you have given me this as the title slide, I assume that it will continue in the same manner. And then when you have more content, which is more important content, I don't want to know which department you are and all that. But when I actually want to know the third law or whatever, then you will be making me difficult to read it. Therefore, if this slide background continues in the further slide, I'll give it one, right? If that person removes this in the next slides, then what will you give? There is no background in the subsequent slides. Then? No, there is no background. It is white. Then what will you give? Will you give 0 or 1 or 2? Still 1. Why? No. Font rating you have to give separately. Okay, so here is that catch. So now don't mix up font rating with this rating. This row you have to click only option for the slide background row. Don't goof up with fonts colors here now. So if all other slides don't have the background, then I don't mind giving it 2, because it is satisfying the section number 2 here, that all the slides are readable without that background. Unfortunately, if the slide background continues to all the slides, then I am going to give 1 or 0. How many 1s? Oh, you are still finding it readable, is it? Okay, fine. And zeros? Okay, lot of them are in zero. So depends actually. And depends is the point here. And that is where it just starts changing. However, please don't mix up rows and columns is my humble suggestion at this point. Because the moment you do that, you are going to goof up the entire result of that person. Go next. Alignment. Is this fully aligned or fully unorganized? It's aligned. So what type of alignment is used? The main bullet and the sub bullet are slightly shifted, right? So people are giving 2, 1, nobody gave 2. Lucknow has given 2, Pune has given 2, and Salem has given 2. Okay, so a lot of people are giving 2 here because the alignment is quite okay. Do you see the heading? Lot of people just notice that there is a heading, right? Okay, but don't rate it for the colors and background in this row right now. Okay, got it? So don't rate it for this here. If there is another section. Now, if the slide presentation is running throughout and you have, so this is the from the same presentation where that guy had switched over that background to only the heading in the subsequent slides as a design element. Okay, now, now whether it has done this, I'll give you a chance on that overall thing in this last row, right? Let us go there. Fourth, fifth. Use of images. This is that question that how much percentage of images is required. So it actually depends on the slide. So are the irrelevant images used? This is about sports and youth. Is it an irrelevant image? Okay. Images are okay, but could have been better. Some images are referred or not referred. So images not referred is also a problem where you can deduct marks for that. So you know that when you add such images, what is going to happen to yourself, right? So never ever take it for granted that every image in the world is for you to use, because, and I have heard this bizarre answer from a teacher, believe me, I found it on Google Images, right? So it is not true. Harshad is here, a strong supporter of open source, and he will probably give multiple lines of why it is not true. But please follow the lines of strictness for using such images. Just because they are available in Google Images doesn't mean that you can use it left, right, and center. There is an option to categorize images which are free for use, free for modification and use, and all such options are present. Please use it. I request people who know these options to tell their colleagues who don't know it. and let us just take this point out of the system forever, because it is not a good idea to admit this point. And I would not like to have at least images which are not referred in any one of your submissions, because of the simple matter that this doesn't require any creative skills for that. You have to just follow norms. There's nothing that the artist should tell you. It is only about the ethical part. So as a teacher, I believe you all are well versed with it, and let us follow that. Okay. So going back to this size of image. So a lot of people were, by the way, all remote centers were jumping between 1 and 2, but nobody gave a 0 to that. Now we can see a lot of zeros suddenly. How many people here also agree with zeros? Yes. Why? Because images are either too tiny or too big, not providing space for other elements. And on what other counts will you give this 0? On use of font, 0. Use of color? Use of alignment? You will give marks to alignment. Exactly. Now you are getting the hang of it, right? So this particular submission doesn't fail on alignment. It fails on colors. It fails on background usage and other. Realize that, right? So, well, last time what happened is that people were carrying out that that mood of that first slide forever. अगर पहला स्लाइड अगर गलत कर दिया है तो बंदे को जीरो ही देते थे. तो पहला ही स्लाइड देखते थे क्योंकि अटैचमेंट में यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट स्लाइड, राइट? जस्ट डोंट ओपन इट एंड जस्ट स्टार्ट गिविंग इट. प्लीज 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 डोंट कमिट सच ब्लंडर्स दिस टाइम, बिकॉज इट्स योर हार्ड अर्न मार्क्स एट स्टेक राइट नाउ. ओके, गो अहेड. एंड आई एम कम टू द लास्ट स्लाइड, सो आई विल ओनली ईट मिनट्स ऑफ द लंच. ओवरऑल इम्पैक्ट. This is where you can take out all your frustration about ye kaisa kiya tha, right? But it will only factor 1/7 of the frustration. So that is where the submission is safe. That was our point. So here you can say fails to communicate totally. That's fine. Or could understand some slides but could not understand some of the slides, which is also fine. But clear communication and presentation should get 2 marks if that is the case. Got it? So I think so for this slide people are saying 1, because if similar slides are there in the entire presentation. Okay, so for this slide, where will this slide not score the mark? For font and for alignment. Yes, why not for alignment? Because these two columns are very bizarre way they are presented, right? Okay, font size, yes, on font size it will not score, on color it will not score, saying alignment, yes. So everybody is agreeing that on font and alignment it will not score, but it will score in other things, correct? So this is how we have to go ahead for this. Go ahead, next slide, if there is anything. Okay, let's talk, but there is no time to talk now. Let's eat should have been the slide actually. But let us, if you all agree, people who are wanting to ask a question or something, I won't mind having my lunch later, because I am not the next speaker anyway going to speak, but you guys have to come back. So if you have questions, please ask them. I am not asking the local guys to ask questions, because I can ask them, they can ask me during the lunch, which hopes. Yeah, we'll go to Jnanamani College. Yeah, you know, suddenly questions are popping up. So lots of questions means 2 things. Either they have understood everything or nothing.
So thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the wonderful presentation, sir. So through this, we have learned how we have to present to the students. And then we have a questions like now in terms of the punctuations, like comma, and then further in all, how we have to follow that. Come on, full stop and all.
Okay, thank you. This is Jnanamani College of Engineering in Namakkal. So thank you very much for the question. So your point is well taken, and I think lots of other remote centers also had the similar questions about it. I remember that one of the consultants of the project, Professor Prakash Vaidya, has given a lecture especially on the language part of it, the commas and the full stops, in fact. And he's so critical that often we give him a black and white paper and it comes out as a red and black paper. So he changes so many corrections in that. We have a very good documented lecture of that. I would request Jayakrishnan and Professor Phatak to maybe we can share that lecture with people as a additional reading. So by the way, just a question. So if I give this as an additional reading material, in the learning techniques what you have learnt, what will this be? This be called as, you learned these LEDs, LBDs, what is this now? If I give another lecture in this format. Get on the chat, please. Somebody is answering on the chat. Okay. It is LXI. Okay, fine. Okay, let us go back to the, transfer the floor to, maybe we can transfer it to Supreme Knowledge in Hooghly.
Now, we see some of the slides, we see that in every slide they put up below date, the logo of the college and the slide number, and it is reflected in all the slides. So I want your suggestion, is it a good practice to do that or it is just distracting? In every slide, if we have bottom the logo of the college, the date and the slide number.
So I think you have asked the Mann Ki Baat for a lot of participants here, and a lot of faculty members are forced to use a template given by their college where the logo is sometimes bigger than the heading and you don't know what to do with it. The simple thing is that you can try to minimize the size of the logo, number one. Second is place it in such a position that it will not obstruct your content, second. Third is convert it into a manner that it will not grab the attention and kind of overtake your script. So your script is that they should read my heading first and the text. But if it is reading the logo first and the text and again the logo and the bullet and again the logo and the third bullet, because the logo is like spinning or rotating and things like that, then in such a case, avoid all these options. In fact, if you see, the good logos are those which are created for multiple usage. And you should just, as a curiosity thing, you can just go ahead and look at logo usage guidelines for the best of the organizations in the world. For example, you go and see WHO. So logo usage guidelines will be another page on their website where they'll say, if you want to use it in a presentation, use this image. If you want to use it on a project report, use this image. If you want to print it on a certificate, use this image. And the certificate would be fully colored, and the one in using on the document would be in a monochromatic way, maybe a black and white thing, and such cases are created specially for that. Even some of the Indian counterparts like NACOM, if you go to their webpage, you will find out these things. And that's essential. I'm not asking you guys to do that because it's out of scope for you. What minimally you can do is you can at least position it in such a way that it will not obstruct your view and still go ahead with your communication. Also, you can control the size of it. So these are the two ways of doing it. But anyway, thank you for an important question. I have one more question here. Deep Patil, College of Engineering in Indapur.
Sir, let me first of all thank you, say thank you and congratulate to IIT Bombay for bringing all of us to a same platform. Maybe a faculty from a remote place or maybe he is from urban. So I would like to thank all of you first. My question is, sir, ki, I want to present any idea in any kind of defense or examination. How much number of slides I have to keep over there for that my presentation? And second, if I am explaining any topic to my student in classroom, so how much slides there I have to keep in so that I can keep the rhythm of that presentation?
Thank you, Indapur, for this question. The question is about the quantity now, right? So all this while we have been talking about quality, and therefore the other extreme has been asked, like, what is about the quantity? How many slides are enough slides? So wherever you have a timeline, it is pretty sure how you use it, but depends on the content actually. So for example, I would like to example from my own presentation right now, where I had a think pair share slide. I was required to make so many slides about it. So I had a thing question pair. So I clubbed everything in one slide and I made one slide out of it. And when I discussed the example about it, I had another this thing and I used the animation feature to show one thing at a time and I could make that. Now if you ask me number of slides, that presentation was showing some 120 slides or something, right? The first presentation, 58 slides, okay. So people had a big suspense in their mind, like, yeah, isko ek ghanta diya hai, 58 slides, 1 minute per slide also, it is not possible. How will it do it? So it is not about that part. It is also about how you time your slides and how much content have you packed on one slide is the actual thing there. So in a classroom, you are sure you are going to get 45 minute slot. And you know, now with this added knowledge of active learning and all that, now you know how much time are you going to spend on interaction with the students. And then you also know that how much time is left for them to read those slides. So in order to do that, you have to accommodate your slides. So for example, if you look at any presentation by Professor Phatak, it has only one word on that. Not even a sentence, and forget about bullets and everything. He will have only one word slides, but he talks about various other sometimes motivational talks and other things that he can afford that. But still, he tries to concise his slides as much as I have seen his computer science lectures also. They are very concise in terms of slides because people can read and download the slides. You don't have to really read each and every word written there. That is another mistake, but I'm not talking about it here of reading the slides. So it depends on how you control that timing in the slide will give you the answer how many slides you want to. In best practices of conducting presentations or conferences, you will always get a sentence at the end that it should not exceed 6 slides or it should be limited to 3 slides or 4 slides, whatever. So they know that only then it can happen in that timing, and they have a good understanding of that. So similar thing can come with experience, that how much time can you spend on each slide, and each slide will give you a different answer actually. So I can't tell you that go by the thumb rule that ek slide 5 minute chalega types. So it's not possible to do that. Let us take one more question. Dronacharya College.
Sir, I have one question and one practice I am doing.
Okay.
I am making use of. Second question will be from my colleague. My first practice I am going to use and using is that there is something called as 10, 20, 30 rule of PowerPoint presentation. 10, 20, 30 rule of PowerPoint presentation. I learned this some 5 years back through some literature review. The 10 first answer it should be not more than 10 slides. 20 says should be not more than 20 minutes. 30 says be not less than 30 font size. 10, 20, 30, 10 slides, 20 minutes, 30 minimum font size. I've added one more thing here. Ten, 20, 30, oblique 3. 3 means 3 bullet points at the most. That is the one practice I am making use of that last many years. And the question is, my question is, why we are using or why we have the option of rehearsal option in the PowerPoint presentation? What is the use of that? Is it really required?
So Dr. Jagpal, thank you very much for a very pertinent question, and thanks for pointing it out, because I don't think so many people have seen that there is an option called rehearse. Those who have seen have not used it practically because they don't know why it is there, first of all. So it is actually for the last bullet on my plan execute impress slide, which is called practice. So once you, the question which was from Indapur about how much slides should be there for my lecture. So this thing answers that. So in fact, yes, PowerPoint has come up with an option that when you are in a presenter mode and it is connected to a projector, you can have differential screens. So one screen which will go to the projector will be the slide in full screen mode. On the other hand, whatever you will have on your computer monitor, sure, will be the next, sure, slide coming up, and also the timer which is shown. So the timer can be used in two ways. One is that you can start with zero, or you can do it as a countdown where you start from 45 minutes and then keep coming down. It will also allow you multiple other options of having your notes displayed, so you don't have to worry about missing out a point and other things. So there are various features which are available not only in PowerPoint, by the way, but in all other open source variants also, if I am right. So the feature is available in OpenOffice and LibreOffice and other places also. Please make use of that, and it will just enhance the thing. So very pertinent factor here. Okay, so I think we stop at this point. But before I go, I just do an announcement. I am offering a course on 3D animation on IIT Bombay X. The registration has started. If you log into IIT Bombay X accounts now, you will be able to see it. This course is a self-paced course, and it is an 8-chapter course. So you can take it in your own speed. It will end up somewhere in December. The registrations will be open up to November, so that anybody who wants to do it can take it up. In my records, the shortest time taken by an individual to finish the course has been 4 days. And there are people who have scored 99 marks by logging into the software only for 4 days. And so that is how things are going up fast for the students of this age. And I request all of you to have a look at it and recommend it to the students who are interested in this as a skill or even as a subject in serious. To tell you some deep thing, more deeper about it, Symbiosis College is taking that course as a elective in their college itself. And they are running this in a blended mode, which means that their students will be enrolled and their local coordinator will be able to see their progress. We will give them a dashboard to see their progress only, and then we will be able to see the overall progress of the course happening everywhere else. But the self-paced mode is allowing them to schedule their lectures at their own time. So if they want every Thursday, Friday, their lectures, then they can just show these lectures at that time. So there is another college in Ratnagiri, Finolex College, which has actually used this course as an elective in their college for last 2 semesters already. There are many more colleges. Rajkot College has been using it, all the remote center, but they go to another college and do it. So there are various models happening. Why this announcement is important is another reason, that I am going to offer a course on computer game creation in mid of October, for which this course is a prerequisite. So students who are interested in game creation and interactive simulations and all that should take this up first and try to finish it off before the next course starts off. So that was a small announcement I wanted to make, because I saw one advertisement in between. I thought I'll also do one more. And with this, I thank you all of all the participants across the country who participated really well. And I don't know how much chat has generated in this session itself, which is very interesting to see. Please go ahead and have a look at the videos. Try to come up with your own ideas about this thing. Please keep submitting them. We have already started a discussion forum about this thing. Please post your comments on that. And we will continue to take it up offline as well. And second announcement was obviously about the animation course. Please go ahead and do that. I have no doubt, because of this tool, what we have in hand, we are definitely going to benefit with each other. People especially who are come there from different colleges and attending at a third party remote center for them, I request you to take this opportunity to make a group in your own city now. And come up with more interaction options with these faculty members. In fact, as easy as option like when you come back from lunch, please don't sit on the same table. Exchange your seats and try to talk and interact with new people every time you come back. That simple gesture will at least make you aware who all attended from this center, right? That much is good enough for making a community, which Professor Fahartegi is dreaming of having for the entire country. So thank you very much for your support, and we sign off.